Guys, it's the first day of New York Fashion Week, and we're heading back into where a lot of these shows are going on right now. But we also just shot E! News for the night, so you have to tune in at 7-Eleven, but this is kind of a little behind-the-scenes access for you. Uh-oh, we're speaking of my credential.
I have it.
Oh, God, thank God. Okay, they won't let you in. They will not let you in without your credential. They don't care who you are. If you're Victoria Beckham, they're like, where's my credential?
Here you go.
Thank you. I'm gonna take you inside the building where we film E! News when we're covering New York Fashion Week, where I'm gonna be doing my stand-ups and seeing you guys on television, and even Daily Pop we're doing live today from New York City.
Drop your love on me. The door kind of slams in your face.
They're gonna ask for your photo.
Hi, thank you. Made it in.
Back door. Full on operation. Okay. This really is kind of what goes on. You know, behind the walls, behind the catwalk. There's a lot of security. Live like dynasty. That's just Parker. I'll chill with you if you want to. What's up? So, this is the middle of the chaos. We're in the car. We got my good friend here. What's your name again? We're that good of friends. Sorry. But it's been that kind of day. Because what I'm doing is I just shot the Daily Pop show. I then shot the E! News wraps. And now, believe it or not, my voice all the way to television is done thanks to Steve Jobs on my Apple telephone. I send the stories for the day all the way to Los Angeles from New York so that they can edit the pieces and put them together for tonight's E! News. So that's literally what I'm doing. I have the scripts here on my phone, and I mean, it's so fancy. I do voice memos. Let me show you. Here's my script right here. Tonight's first story is, it's a wrap up of last night's big party that we had with Elle Magazine, the E, L, and IMG kickoff party for New York Fashion Week. And you guys want to be here when I do this? Okay, let me change hands. Very, very fancy, high technology. And da-da-da. All right, here we go. 3, 2. The stars, the glam, and all the amazing fashion. We're kicking off New York Fashion Week with Elle Magazine's Personal Style Awards. Just like that, that's what we do. Ashen, are you? Drop your love on me.
Over Fashion Week, this is a big deal for E!
Yeah, there's nothing we're not doing. We've got every single platform covered. The digital,
that.
The television, my new show, which is also very early, like yours.
What is this?
It's called Daily Pop. My favorite thing about this show is the fact that it's just super ad-libbed, off the cuff, raw, unscripted, is that we have a really nice exchange with the audience. Until 2 a.m. Come on, Sadler, wake it up. Eyes open. Here we go. So we are on our way to see the very gifted and talented Rebecca Minkoff, the designer. We're doing a whole day with her, essentially, and our friends at Tresemme. So we're actually focusing on the glam today and mostly the hair on the models that complete her new look for her latest collection. So we're kind of getting a hair tutorial. We're hearing how important the glam is to the expression of the clothes when they actually hit the catwalk. So that's it. First stop, Rebecca Minkoff, and it's sunny, it's Saturday, we're in New York, we're craving pizza. This is New York Fashion Week. You love me.
Make sure you're rolling up so we can lay back and smoke up.
What are we talking about? Are you rolling? We're just talking about Handmaid's Tale.
and it has nothing to do with New York Fashion Week. Praise be. Under his eye, blessed be
when
thy fruit.
When you say praise be, like what occasion?
Praise be. Well, because the maids are slaves in this show, and anytime anything happens whatsoever, they don't get to express their true opinion, so they just say, praise be. Like, it's God's will, you know? The fact that I can't leave my house, and I can't read a book, and I can't watch television, praise be.
So what do you say, praise be?
Well, I just was live on E! News, Daily Pop, kind of around the world, and I had this pain, like, this IFB is what we call the thing in our ear so that we can actually hear the other hosts and talk about what we're talking about. And I was talking about Rihanna, and the whole time there was this sound in my ear going, and like, but I couldn't let the world know that, and I had to keep my thoughts together and keep speaking, and the show must go on, and the whole time that piercing, horrific sound is in my ear. And the words that came to me when it was over were, praise be. If you want to drop your love on me, that's just wrong. That's just how you, that's just wrong. That's just how you drop your love on me. This is the behind the scenes behind the scenes. We are filming E! News, and Morgan Stewart is literally 20 feet over that way filming her bit for E! Digital. See how we do? We're everywhere, people. You can't escape us. We're taking over New York Fashion Week. Get familiar. Hey, Jim Carrey. Yes?
What?
I've covered a lot of Fashion Weeks. This is the first time I've run in to Jim Carrey. Wait, tell me, is it true you're wandering the streets? You need a date to the party? What's up?
No. I'm doing just fine. I just, there's no meaning to any of this. So I wanted to find the most meaningless thing that I could come to and join, and here I am.
They're celebrating.
I mean, you got to admit it's completely meaningless.
Well, they say they're celebrating icons inside.
Celebrating icons, boy, that is just the absolute lowest aiming, you know, possibility that we could come up with. It's like icons. What do you believe in icons? I don't believe in personalities. I don't believe that you exist, but there is a wonderful fragrance in the air.
I never thought I'd be at New York Fashion Week talking about Jim Carrey of all people. But yeah, our interview seems to be getting not just a little traction, but a lot of traction. I just was told it's gotten 17 million views on the E! Facebook page. Jim's just being a little quirky and odd and out there and wants to talk about existential happenings. And yeah, a lot of people talking about it. So, but it's funny because I'm getting emails from people in the business and friends and PR people and other reporters, like, congratulations on the Jim Carrey interview because it's gone viral. So a lot of people saying such wonderful, nice things on how I handled it, like a consummate professional. They would have not known what to do. I did such a great job. And then other people that I do not know on social media and trolls are saying that I should, let's see if I can find anyone. Someone go pinch this chick.
What?
I should be ashamed of myself. But anyway, you get the idea. It's been interesting to say the least. I trip when I take a step because I'm always thinking of you. You feel all that I give, because that's just how you're supposed to. It's day 7 of New York Fashion Week, and I'm on my way to be interviewed myself from Teen Vogue and In Touch magazine. Talk a little fashion, talk a little trends, talk a little celebrity. And I feel really good, I gotta say. I got a great night's sleep last night. I think I slept 8.5 hours. It was awesome. But this is about the time of the trip where I'm really missing my kids a lot. I talked with both of them last night on the phone, and I don't think they miss me as much as I miss them, but that's a good thing. It's actually pretty crazy. I'm gonna hit the ground running when we get back to LA because of Emmys and a Simply Stylist event I'm doing down in the OC. I kind of knew this stretch of September was gonna be totally manic, so I prepared myself mentally. I'm not gonna get emotional. We're just gonna keep hustling, keep getting that paper, keep killing life. You know, you just don't know what could happen. It's Tuesday. I mean, Saturday was Jim Carrey. Today it could be, like, I could run into Johnny Depp on the streets of New York, and we could, you know, I might just have an in-depth interview with him about all those millions he supposedly spent and what's really happened with Amber Heard. You just don't know what's gonna happen. So that is the energy I'm putting out today. You just don't know. I believe in miracles. We're attracting fun. We're attracting the unexpected. We're attracting flies. Just kidding. And do you think that was funny? I think he laughed. Maybe not. And that's really it. I don't know if you can see it. Oh shoot, you can see my boob tape, Ginger.
What? No, you can't.
So Ginger, behind the camera this morning, you all know the world famous Ginger, director of the catwalk, camera person, paparazzi assistant, coder, margarita maker, steamer, wardrobe assistant. Ginger, she had the pleasure, I don't think it was pleasure, she had the task of putting on my boob tape this morning. And if you're unfamiliar with boob tape, it's essentially, it's amazing. It's like you put it under your boob and then you lift up your boob and then you attach the sticker to the top and it literally moves your boob up like a whole inch.
Let's check them out.
A bra, but look, you can kind of see it, Ginger. So that's, we're gonna have to keep an eye on that today because Teen Vogue probably would not.
Bennett will fix that.
Yeah. I don't think Teen Vogue would be impressed with my, Animateur would not like the boob tape showing. We gotta fix this. This is a fashion emergency. Holy shit, relate. Trip when I kiss your lips, cause you taste just like mimosas. You feel all that I give, cause that's just how you're supposed to. Hey guys, this is Winnie from E-Zone China. How cool is this? So we're gonna do a little thing where I'm gonna speak English and you're gonna translate in Chinese. In Chinese. Okay, this is cool. Let's hope I can remember what I'm supposed to say.
I stand by everyone, one moment. And camera's rolling.
E-Zone YouTube VIPs. Catch all the latest celebrity news with me, Kat Sadler, on E-News. How was that? Your turn?
Yeah, I know.
Hi, nice to meet you, Kat.
大家好,我是Winnie文文雅,各位UIP的部分。Sorry.
Sorry. Let's do it again.
UIP. It should be. Yeah.
Good, see? We messed up in every language. Yeah. I mean, that's just how. It's just so hard to translate from English.
I'm sure.
I have enough trouble with English. I'm good news, too. Okay, yeah. We'll try it again.
Yeah. Okay, stand by. And camera's rolling.
Welcome to E-Zone, Youku VIPs. Catch all the latest celebrity news with me, Kat Sadler, on E-News.
Hi Kat, I'm Li Wen. 各位优酷的VIP会员大家好,我是文雅。各位呢,一定要锁定 E-Zone, 因为这里有最新的名人资讯和好莱坞的资讯哦,不要锁定。
This movie. I always get a little nervous when I see you because I watch you so much.
Shush. Jennifer, don't.
I really do.
I'm going to fangirl on you. Let's not do this. Nervous? Did you really say that?
Yeah, I'm like on E. I always watch E.
You love E. I know the Kardashians are your favorite.
Yes. Okay.
But we want to talk about your movie.
Well, kids, we came, we saw. This is the final ride. We're headed to JFK. I have just taken off my gown. I've taken off my dress that I interviewed Jennifer Lawrence in just moments ago. I'm getting in my airport gear. I even have on my Spanx from my dress. So I didn't pack the appropriate underwear. Don't do that at home. And yeah, this is the glamorous life right here. Just changed in the car. I'm ready to go home. I think it's been a stellar New York Fashion Week. I mean, Rihanna, Jennifer Lawrence, Kim Kardashian. Jim Carrey, we went viral, people. We went viral. And I heard from the trolls, and you know what? What doesn't kill you doesn't, what is it? To all the trolls out there, whatever doesn't kill you makes you stronger. I think Kanye said that one. So I am ready to get back to my babies, my boys. Can't wait to hug and kiss them. They're gonna be in my house tonight. And I'm gonna collapse with them. But before I go, the woman holding the camera, the young female that is Ginger Duran slayed this week. I could not have done this without her. So you better go follow Ginger Duran. Follow her Instagram.
Oh, battery died.
No, it did
just
not.
Kidding.
She is the wind beneath my wings, and that is a fact.
Love you.
Love you.